On a very basic level, regulators provide a way to control the pressure of gas or other fluids to downstream processes or customers. Self-operated regulators work to meet or fulfill downstream demand while keeping downstream pressure constant. To understand self-operated regulators today, you need to know a little bit about why and how they were invented. It began in the 1800s when engineer mechanic William Fisher left his home in Mississippi to work as a chief engineer for Marshalltown, Iowa. Fisher manually maintained the water pressure for firefighters. Now, he had to do this by hand from a steam-driven pump carried on a wagon. When the firefighters first attacked the fire, they needed as much water as possible. After hooking up the hoses, the gauge gave Fisher the signal to begin the pump and man the valve. As the pump started, the steam pressure decreased. As this happened, Fisher opened the valve to make the pump work faster in order to supply enough water to put out the fire. When there was less demand for water, the firefighters throttled back on the nozzle, the pump slowed down, and the pressure in the line increased. At this point, Fisher closed the valve.
Whew, this is hard work. There has to be another way.
Yes, exhausted from hand throttling the pump throughout the night, Fisher decided to invent a way to more easily maintain constant pressure to the pumps. He developed a self-contained valve and actuator combination that operates off its own inertia. Many months later, Fisher developed the Fisher Type 1 Constant Pressure Pump Governor, which he patented in 1880. That original design is the basis for today's self-operated regulators. As you begin working with self-operated regulators, we hope that you will remember William Fisher and his original Type 1 Constant Pressure Governor.